In this video, I want to go through the two options, Nintendo Switch versus the mobile, and determine which option is better to play Pokémon Unite with. So let's begin. So first, I want to talk about Nintendo Switch. If you have this console, it's very straightforward and simple. You just download the game from the eShop and start playing. Some people do like to use this in handheld mode using the Joy-Cons, and some people do prefer the Pro Controller while it's connected to the dock and using the TV. This is very simple and self-explanatory, and Pokémon Unite as a game is very well done considering it's a MOBA for the console. I personally think the old school dock setup while using Pro Controller is the best way to play this game. But user experience might vary and some people do prefer the handheld mode, but that's totally up to a personal preference. The only downside I have for this game when playing with the Switch is the performance. You have to keep in mind that the Nintendo Switch's performance isn't the most optimal. When you have bigger team fights in the game, when there is a lot of action happening in the screen at the same time, you're guaranteed to lose some frames, which means that you won't be having a consistent 60 FPS all the time. Other than that, I think the experience on Nintendo Switch is great. Now I want to talk about mobile. So mobile phones are more accessible. There are more people in the world owning mobile phones than Nintendo Switches, which means that it's more accessible to players globally. It just comes down to the fact how powerful your phone is. If you have older phone, you're pretty guaranteed to experience hiccups in the game, which again means that you're gonna have a lower FPS. But with newer phones, and even tablets, I would even argue that you can get better performance than using the Nintendo Switch. So when you think about the performance aspect of things, with some of the latest hardware on the market, you can make this game run better with mobile devices than on the Nintendo Switch. When I tested this game on mobile, the product I am using is the iPhone SE 2020 model, and quite frankly, I was getting pretty good results in terms of performance. But you also want to keep in mind that this phone is about 1 year old, so it's relatively fresh from the market. However, I'm not personally a big fan of the touch controls in mobile. As you can see from this gameplay, I'm really struggling to execute things when using my fingers while pressing them towards the screen. My background comes from console gaming as well as PC gaming, so trying to play an action game on the phone is very challenging for me. But you also want to keep in mind this is something very personal to me. Some people can prefer the touch controls if they're more accustomed to those. So the bare bones mobile experience is in my opinion worse than the bare-bones Switch experience because of the controls, even despite the fact that you have higher chances to get better performance when using the phone. But there is a catch to all of this. If you want to really put things on the next level and you have money to spend, I could argue that you can get the ultimate experience on mobile. There are ways to connect several types of controllers, such as Xbox controller to phone, which means that you can eliminate the touch controls. There are also additional devices that you can use to connect your mobile to TV or monitor. So technically you could get the same docked setup that you could get with the Switch, but you just need tools and additional third-party devices to execute that. Let's say if you have a really powerful phone or a really powerful tablet, let's say the newest iPad from the market, you connect a controller to that and possibly also connect that into your monitor or TV. That could be the ultimate experience for Pokémon Unite. But you want to keep in mind that not all of the third-party controllers are compatible with the mobile devices. And quite frankly, I'm not sure which devices support mobile and are there differences between Android and iOS, but I've heard at least that the Xbox controller works well, so there's that. So the TLDR is that if your phone is powerful enough, you connect controller to that via Bluetooth, then connect the phone or tablet to a TV or monitor, you can get the ultimate experience with Pokémon Unite. But that is going to cost more money than let's say a Nintendo Switch does. But I am pretty sure that the performance aspect is much better on a high-end mobile device compared to Nintendo Switch, which is really interesting and important to think about from a competitive aspect. I am running at 1500s Masters right now. I am super into this game from competitive perspective, so all of this really piques my interest. But the fact that do I want to spend up to several hundred euros or dollars for this all to happen? Maybe, eventually. But for now, I'm gonna stick on the Switch version of the game. But this is something I want to keep in mind for later, and for the viewers too. I think this is pretty important piece of news. The last thing I want to mention is heating. Both Nintendo Switch and mobile devices will be gaining heat when you do gaming sessions, especially if they're long. Depending on the device on mobile and how well you can cool it, you could improve the cooling aspect of the device. From what I can tell from Switch's side, the third-party cooling devices seem to be kinda iffy, so as far as I can tell, there's not really a solid cooling solution for Switch, but this could be another story with the mobile devices. But that comes to really down dependent on the mobile device itself. Is it Android? Is it iOS? So you also want to keep that in mind. So that concludes my discussion on the matter. Which setup do you prefer? Nintendo Switch, bare bones mobile, or the advanced Kinect controller hook it up to TV monitor setup? Let me know down in the comments, because I'm very curious to know how are you operating this game and which device you're using to play it. If you found this video enjoyable, a thumbs up would be appreciated. And with that said, thank you so much for watching. My name is Hepodix, and I hope you have a wonderful day.